Throughout this course, we've discussed human thought and behavior as processes that are driven by both nature and nurture. And this lesson on mental illness epitomizes the dynamic interplay between the two.
That's right. And as we said throughout the course, we are like little chemical factories, making chemicals that help us live successfully in our environment. But as you've seen from this lesson, sometimes there can be a tragic disconnect between our individual nature and nurture experience, which can result in mental illness.
Although this lesson is sobering, we really hope that it shows you to be thankful the times that you're experiencing positive mental health.
That's right. And remember that it's not unusual for us to experience highs and lows throughout our life, periods of anxiety or depression, but it's when we don't have these experiences that we should be fortunate and thankful for our good mental health.
Now that you've completed this lesson, we hope that you're a more educated person in the terms of mental health literacy, and that any negative stereotype or stigma that you may have once had are now diminished or completely removed.
We as humans are unique and fascinating creatures, and it's not uncommon for us to experience difficulties in this sometimes challenging world. However, when those difficulties manifest themselves through mental illness, that can be challenging in and of itself. However, as we'll see in the next lesson, there are a variety of techniques that can help reduce the symptoms of mental illness such that people can live fulfilling, meaningful, adventurous, and proud lives. There's absolutely no shame in mental illness. And in our next lesson, we're going to learn about the treatments for mental disorders.